using speakers. Some speakers, some speakers invite debate. And as I said in my article, debate is the lifeblood of democracy. It's really important. So it's important to invite people who will initiate discussion and debate around provocative, controversial, and even offensive ideas, and particularly on college campuses, because debate opens minds. But paid full speech closes minds, so just don't invite those people. And the second point that I made, let me finish, because it's really important. It's important to make the point, right?
Okay,
that
the second point
that I made is that at this particular moment in time, hateful speech is particularly problematic because we live in a culture that is on social media.
This is how slow, that's how slow we can get.
And now we have politicians who just lob the F-bomb at one another. And this kind of verbal aggression, if it goes on for long enough, is harmful to your nervous system. It makes people more likely to be sick.
I'm going to ask you a question.
Yeah.
I got it. So, obviously this is a pretext for censorship. My question remains the same, which is who decides what speech can be heard? You're arguing against allowing all speech.